coming up next, a matchup to determine the baddest man on the planet. The UFC heavyweight title is on the line. Well, for a long time, he's been mentioned with the baddest men on the planet. For a long time, though, the title fight eluded him. Not anymore. Here he is, the number one heavyweight contender, finally making this walk and cracking a smile. He's waited a long time for this. He's not expecting a 25-minute war. He believes he has the power and the skills to get this thing done quickly. I guess we'll find out. So here he is making his way to the Octagon for another heavyweight title defense. This has been the baddest man on the planet now for several years, and he has taken on all comers more often than not, leaving them twitching on the canvas, knockout power for days. The question is tonight, with a challenge like this, can he walk out the way he came in as the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world? Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight championship fight. Volkov is 5 years the elder. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. And now with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Eve Loving. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Toyota Center in Houston, Texas, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC heavyweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 42 wins, 11 losses. He stands 6'7" tall, weighing in at 250 pounds.
Fighting out of Moscow, Russia, presenting the challenger, Alexander Drago Volkov. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 31 wins, 3 losses.
He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Makovsky.
UFC belt on the line, guys. Protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
The baddest man on the planet, there he is in the flesh. He has defended this title in the past, and despite the fact that this has been a belt that has changed hands quite a bit, not since this man has held it down. We'll see if he can keep his championship legacy going here tonight. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Oh, nice elbow.
Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish his fight.
Well, straight right hand has been a good weapon for him. He misses with it there.
Big punch lands. Ooh.
Strong defense here as the hook to the head is blocked. Oh, he's got that right hand going tonight, DC. Connected with it there.
He's thrown so many left jabs to throw that right punch straight down the pipe. It's unreal.
Oh, and he defends another takedown there, so looked like a pretty good entry, but once again, unable to get him down.
Great balance, great awareness, moved the head back inside, turned that double into a single, sprawled, and got away from his opponent. Great job.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Oh, straight right. Lands a big elbow there. Well, he's got the kicking game going tonight. Lands another one there.
A beautiful kick, and all I can think of, better him than me.
Volkov's strike attempt there is blocked. And he defends yet another takedown. Seemingly every takedown attempt that has been tried has been stuffed. Oh, lands a stiff punch there. Nice connection.
Oh, nice land.
Oh, wicked nice leg kick there, DC.
Can't take too many of those.
Oh, collar tied. Oh, nice land with the knee. You see the taller fight. And maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
Oh, and there's that double leg takedown. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Oh, wow, that happened quickly as the fighter reverses.
Now he'll try to start attacking a rear naked choke from the top position. Job of relaxing, not panicking because he's getting choked.
He might get a finish here.
Yeah, notice he just took the body triangle, readjust the lock, and now it looks like he's got it.
The sheer will is really remarkable to watch. All right, side control now, DC. When you get side control in a fight, what are you looking for?
When I get to the side control in the fight, and I believe this young man should do the same thing, it's secure first. Grab everything in tight. He jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock. And if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle. Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is in his motions on the mat.
Seconds left. All right, side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Well, you see all the graphic repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on the ground.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. A stunner there with the head strike midway through. Nearly got him out of there for good.
Almost got him out of there. He hurt him badly. He had his opponent hurt real bad. Now his opponent's walking back, and this fight is going.
That was beautiful, man. You had him hurt. You should have put him away. He was- was hurt.
All right, next round is underway. Defense doesn't win championships, but I know you liked what you saw out of him fighting off of his back there in the previous round.
Well, you can't be on your back just getting brutalized. And he did a fantastic job of limiting the damage from the bottom. Was able to control his opponent's posture. Was able to throw up a couple submissions.
Oh, a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed up there.
I mean, when you get hit with a system like that, to stay standing shows and come to your toughness.
Really timing his shots nicely. Good tempo, very accurate, finding the range with relative ease.
Yeah, he's doing a great job of really overwhelming his opponent with activity.
The takedown, it wasn't for any lack of effort, but finally that shot was good enough to get his opponent down.
I don't know how many times, John, I could have watched this guy shoot takedown attempts without securing one. It's almost like out of pity, you feel good for him to finally get it done. Now what does he do with this top control?
Volkov's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. All right, he's got the hooks in, DC, working off of his back.
Now look for him to attack the neck of his opponent to try to get the rear choke.
Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground, and that's very important. But what he has to do here is just try to stay relaxed. Big explosive actions, panicky actions, are what gets you submitted a lot of times.
Ground and pound strike there now.
He's putting him in exactly the position he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here, and he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that...
Wow! Oh, and there comes the stoppage!
Holy smokes!
Just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knockout. Is inside the octagon. It resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 38 seconds of round number two. Playing the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Volkovsky.
So heavyweight title retained is the headline inside this arena here tonight. Congratulations to the still heavyweight champ. Once again, proving he's the elite among the elite.
In a division where everything can change in a second, this guy has brought consistency to something that is so volatile. What a champion, what a fighter. He remains the heavyweight champion of the world.
So much love that the whole thing feel like a lie.